We want to solve the system of equations by using the substitution method. The substitution method is an algebraic method for solving a system of equations. The solution to a system of equations is an ordered pair, or an x and y value, that would satisfy both of the equations. And one more thing we should keep in mind is that when solving a system of equations, it's possible to have one unique solution consisting of an x and y value, but it's also possible to have no solutions or even an infinite number of solutions. The first step in the substitution method is to solve one of these equations for one of the variables. But notice how the second equation is already solved for y. We're given that y equals negative x plus 4. So we're going to use this second equation and perform substitution into the first equation for y. Again, since y is equal to negative x plus 4, we can replace the y in the first equation with negative x plus 4. And to keep this organized, let's call this equation 1, and we'll call this equation 2. So using equation 2, we'll substitute into equation 1, so we'll have x minus, instead of 3 times y, we'll now have 3 times negative x plus 4 equals negative 24. Notice how by doing this, we have one equation with one variable, and now we can solve for x. So the first step here is to clear the parentheses by distributing. So we'll have x. You can think of this as distributing in negative 3. So negative 3 times negative x is positive 3x. So we have plus 3x. And then since negative 3 times positive 4 is negative 12, we'll write minus 12. X plus 3x is the same as 1x plus 3x. So here we'd have 4x minus 12 equals negative 24. Next step here, we'll add 12 to both sides. So we have 4x equals negative 12. Divide both sides by 4. And we have x equals negative 3. Now we need to be careful here because we're not done. Remember, the solution consists of an ordered pair or an x and y value. But now that we know that x must be equal to negative 3, we can perform substitution into equation 2 to determine the value of y. Using equation 2, we know that y must equal negative x, but x is negative 3. So we'll have negative negative 3 plus 4. Well, the opposite of negative 3 or negative negative 3 is positive 3. So we have y equals 7. So our solution would be the ordered pair, negative 3 comma 7. Or if we wanted to, we could list this as x equals negative 3 and y equals positive 7. So we have one unique solution, and therefore we can say that the system is consistent and the equations are independent. But the whole idea here is that x equals negative 3 and y equals positive 7 will satisfy both of these equations. So let's go ahead and just check that. And then we'll also check it graphically. So using equation 1 with x equals negative 3 and y equals 7, we would have negative 3 minus 3 times 7 equals negative 24. This would be negative 3 minus 21 equals negative 24, which is true. So this shows it satisfies the first equation. And then we'll check equation 2 as well. We have y equals negative x plus 4, where y is 7 and x is negative 3. And this would be 7 equals 3 plus 4, and 7 equals 7. So that checks as well. So this does verify that our solution is correct. Remember, when we solve these equations graphically, we graph both lines on the same coordinate plane, and this was the point of our intersection. So let's go ahead and check this graphically as well. The blue line is the graph of equation 1, and the red line is the graph of equation 2. Notice that their point of intersection here has an x-coordinate of negative 3 and a y-coordinate of positive 7, which again verifies our solution. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.